gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. This Sunday, we celebrate the solemnity of the Ascension of our Lord. After 40 days, Jesus ascended into heaven to be united with the Father, to bring forth power and strength to the disciples that he made them strong so that they can go out and make disciples. In a way, you and I are the fruits of the discipleship that the Lord commissioned on the apostles. And each and every one of us are called to make disciples. The Mass is a moment of joy to recharge us, to become witness to the ascension of Christ living with us. That's why Jesus promised, I will be with you forever. And so let's acknowledge the divine presence of God who is truly with us, and I ask the Lord for mercy and strength as we pray. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do.
Through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
God in the highest, and on earth peace
us pray. O God, whose Son today ascended to the heavens, as the apostle looked on, grant, we pray, that in accordance with his promise, we may be worthy for him to live with us always on earth, and we with him in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instruction through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days, you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men dressed in white garments stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy, a blare of trumpets for the Lord.
For King of all the earth is God, sing hymns of praise. God reigns over the nations, God sits upon his holy throne.
God mounts his throne to shouts of joy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to his call. What are the riches of glory in his inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe? In accord with the exercise of his great might, which he worked in Christ, raising him from the dead and seating him at the right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And he put all things beneath his feet and gave him as head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Teach all nations, says the Lord. I am with you always until the end of the world.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mount to which Jesus had ordered them. When they saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, "All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of age." Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Once again, I want to welcome and thank you all for being here to celebrate the solemnity of the Ascension of our Lord. The Ascension of our Lord is a great way for us to be remembered where the head has gone, the body has to follow. It is crystal clear the way that Jesus made this possible for us to see through our physical eyes, so that we can have the foretaste of heaven. These days after Easter, Jesus has appeared to the disciples and he talked to them about eternal life, about heaven several times. Over and over again, he affirmed to them, heaven is for real. The Son of God is going back to the Father who sent him, going to be reunited. The Son of God has the mission to come on earth, and he fulfilled it, and then he commissioned the same mission to the disciples. It took him for 3 years and 40 days for him to make sure the disciples are ready. And now he is again promising them the advocate, the paraclete, the Holy Spirit, for them to be strong. And so therefore, sisters and brothers, this feast is such an important fact that creates a lot of impact within us. There is so much in this passage that we can unpack. The first reading, wherein Luke talks about the glory of Christ. The second reading, St. Paul talks about the mighty deed that the Lord has done through Jesus. There are two things that I would love to emphasize at the beginning of it. One is about death and the resurrection. The second is about the ascension and the commissioning of Jesus. Death and resurrection. Right after death, Jesus rose from the dead and he showed them that he is alive. Is physically alive in body, spirit, and soul. The resurrection of Christ. And the second part is ascension and then the commissioning. The resurrection of Christ is not just, spiritual thing. It is one thing that made every disciple to be resurrected. From all their inclination, from all their, human weaknesses. Now we all heard all these weeks that, we are witnesses to Christ whom you put to death. And it is in the name of Jesus we made the crippled walk. It is through the name of Jesus that we are able to stand and we are ready to die. This power, this strength, this courage was not human. It is through the power of the ascension, of the resurrection of Christ that we celebrate today. Sometimes as we think about the ascension, Jesus is going up to heaven and so he is leaving us, abandoned. But that is not the case. It is not a moment of distance. It is not a moment to think about the absence of Christ, not at all. That's why Christ clearly lays out, I will be with you at all times. St. Paul even beautifully, manifests the way, Jesus Christ died and rose again. And God brought forth mighty power. Not only the people followed him, believed in him, and followed him, but also generations to come will believe and feel the power of God. That's where you and I come, sisters and brothers. That you and I have the same privilege the disciples received for us to taste and see the goodness of God, the mighty power of God alive in our heart, in our church, in our community, in our world, even to this crazy world. We got to open our hearts and minds to see the power and the mercy of God working in us. That work in the community of Ephesians. That's why Paul is so beautifully bringing us to us. The glory of God, the mighty grace of God is so poured upon us so abundantly. And so, dear Ephesians, lift up your hearts and proclaim the name of Christ. that Jesus Christ is the true Son of God, that Jesus Christ, the true Son of God, who ascended to be seated at the Father so that he can empower each disciple who believes, who comes to believe, who comes to be baptized. That's where the commissioning comes. We are baptized in the name of the Father, the Creator, Son Jesus, the Redeemer, and the Holy Spirit, the Sanctifier. The Holy Trinity empowers us every single day. The mighty power of God. The ascension of Christ is the ascension for us to completely believe in heaven and also the true presence of God here on earth. That's why I said it is not an absence, it is not a distance, it is about the true presence of God at all times. You know, these days we have a lot of, you know, celebration, especially the graduation, you know, celebrations, baccalaureate mass everywhere, and celebrations everywhere. You know, as a man who is born in a different country, and I think about myself, and there are so many of you who've been born in a different country and who came here for a better life. And because of your presence here, your hard work here, you brought so much life to your family back in the country that you come from. And I'm one of them. And I also wanted to talk to our young people over here, those of you graduated, you know, these days. What a success, what a victory, what an accomplishment. You brought so much, you know, a proud moment for your family. I'm thinking about that baccalaureate moment when your name is called out. As a young man, you get up from your seat and you walk to the stage. What an ascension from the seat that you're elevated and everybody applauds. You come here and your name is called out, and then everybody calls, you know, summa, you know, your grade is being called out. And, you know, after that you are given a moment to talk about the success of your, you know, your summa cum laude. And then you say, Dad and Mom, I dedicate my graduation to you. It is because your hard work, it is because your sacrifice that you send me to school, that I stand here before you with this graduation, which gives me a, you know, beautiful, strong wings that I can fly, that I can be successful wherever I go. And you started it. You made it possible. I'm applying that to our ascension, sisters and brothers. The ascension of that little boy, little girl, which a parent started. They put them in a good school. They provided everything, you know, food over the table and roof over the head and everything the child needed, the parents provided by their hard work, what they sacrificed. Not even once they complained about, oh, my child is a burden. No parent would ever do that. Upon this day, when they see their own child ascended to a different level, my son is a graduate. My son is well accomplished. My son, I'm so proud of my son that he's going to be successful in his life. I'm so proud of him. That's an ascension. And the child to dedicate to the parents, it is another ascension. Now, after the graduation, what the child would do, maybe he's going to pursue a higher education or maybe he's going for a job. That means he has to leave the town. He's going to leave the town, which is going to break their, you know, parents' heart. But they're not going to stop him. Yes, my son, I'm so proud of you. Please go, accomplish whatever you can. Go, be yourself. You're my son, I'm proud of yourself. And he goes for a job or he goes for another higher study, whatever it is. That moment is an ascension. It is not a distance. It is not an absence of the love of a father for a son or a daughter. That's exactly happening here. Jesus knew that disciples are graduating now, that they can be on their own, go and make disciples. In the name of Jesus, wherever a son or daughter go, they will always think about, you know, their parents. How much my mom loved, how much my dad poured out his grace, you know, his mercy upon me, how much my siblings loved me. That love will never, ever be taken away from a son or daughter who acknowledges the true presence of a mom and dad at all times, all through his life, until death do him apart. That's a huge way for us to, a practical way and a huge way for us to understand what is ascension. And so again, I wanted to emphasize, it is not a distance, it is not an absence, it is to pour out the abundance of God's presence into every single one disciple. And today it is for you and me to feel the power of the ascending God. That the Lord pours out as he's seated at the right hand of the Father, and as he sends the Holy Spirit, and the disciples are going to be more strong and more powerful. That's why, you know, every time you and I make the sign of the cross, it brings so much power and strength. The same way that you and I are baptized in the Catholic Church, the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Maybe today I want to close it with this, you know, closing mark. A little boy was always a little mischievous. So what happened one day, because, you know, parents are disciplining and teachers are disciplining, everywhere you go, they call him something, you know, always trouble, whatever. So one day what he did was he climbed on the tall tree in his house, and he scared them all. He threatened them all that he's going to jump and then he's going to kill himself. Everybody's so scared. Oh, my son, please don't do that. We were trying to help you. Please don't hurt yourself. You're hurting your mama, your papa, everybody's hurting. We're crying. Please, I beg you, come down. We will be nice to you. Mom's words didn't help the son. Dad also cried out, my son, I beg you, please don't hurt yourself. Please come. You can be yourself. We're not going to disturb you. Nothing helped. The class teacher came that way, and they asked him, please, look at our son. I know, you know, you hurt sometime. Please, can you tell him to come down? Okay, my friend, please come down. I will not do you any homework. I'll be easy on you. Please come down. Nothing helped. And here comes the parish priest, and then as he's walking there, and they begged him, Father, please help my son. He's going to hurt himself. The priest came. He did not say anything. He looked up, looked down, and he lifted his hands and said, everybody's so poor priest, he doesn't know anything other than the sign of the cross. So they were all looking down. By the time the sun is down already. Really? Is this real? My son, what made you? We all gave you so much promise. What did this poor priest do that he came down so soon? Well, I know you all guys what you say, but he said something very concrete. Come down, otherwise I'll cut the tree. Sign of the cross has power. That's why every time you're scared, you make the sign of the cross. Sign of the cross, because you're calling out the Holy Trinity to come to be with you, to strengthen you, to empower you. That's the commissioning that you and I received when we were baptized. That's why every time, you know, we go out and come in, we are asked to make the sign of the cross. Every time, you know, when you receive a blessing from your parent or your elders, they bless you. Sign of the cross. When somebody dies, what do? Sign of the cross. The first blessing and the last blessing is the Holy Trinity. Because that's the power that Christ commissioned on the disciples, that we become his followers. We become his lovers. Because that allows us to know him more clearly and love him more dearly. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Please stand for the creed. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation,
He came down from heaven.
By the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary. He came man.
For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With trust in one who speaks to us from above and knows all our needs, we now pray.
That all who have been entrusted with the word of the Lord may proclaim it without hesitation or fear. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That as Christ's disciples, we may be effective witnesses to the gospel of life which has been entrusted to us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That men and women discerning their vocation will not let their hearts be troubled or afraid, but rather will find comfort and guidance in the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For family members who have strayed from the church, that our example of holiness may bring them back quickly. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For family members and parishioners in the hospital or nursing homes, or seriously ill at home, that the healing spirit of God may be upon them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who have died may have eternal rest, and that we may always thank the Lord for their lives, especially Frank Nelson, Kathy Sexton, Mildred Raleigh, Nick and Jack Bush. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That seated at the right hand of his Father in heaven, the Lord will share his wisdom with those discerning their vocation and open their eyes and hearts in faithfulness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father, you have made your word known to us in Jesus, your Son. As you answer our prayers, give us the grace to be his witness in the world, for he is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
We want
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated ever living at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and there obtain your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder, mediator between God and man, judge of the world and the Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head, the founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Glorified, O God, who love him and family, who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scripture and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify this gift of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By your partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion together with Francis, our Pope, Myron, our Bishop, with all other bishops, with priests and deacons, with your entire people. Grant that all the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of times, by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all, that sharing their grief and pain, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, we may come to eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles, and all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command and form thy divine teaching, together we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
The sins of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. The body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Let us pray. May the gifts we have received from your altar, O Lord, kindle in our hearts a longing for heavenly homeland and cause us to press forward, following in the Savior's footsteps, to the place where, for our sake, he entered before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. As it was announced earlier about the Father Gilbert's retirement, today we have a date for a retirement party. So please save the date, Sunday, June 25th, after the 12:30 p.m. Spanish Mass to celebrate Father Gilbert's retirement. More details to follow in the bulletin. The Knights of Columbus and Legion of Mary invite all the parish families to our monthly Chaplet of Divine Mercy and Family Rosary to be held on Sunday, May 28th, 3 p.m. in the church. Congratulations to Mary Ferraria, our office manager, on her retirement. We are grateful for her 17 years of service. And may God continue to bless her and her family. And let's continue to keep her in our prayers. And that means we are looking forward to have a new office manager. And for the details, look at the bulletin and the website. Please stand for the final blessing. Please bow your heads for a final blessing. May Almighty God bless you, for on this very day, his only begotten Son pierced the heights of heaven and unlock for you the way to ascend where he is. Amen.
Amen.
May he grant that as Christ, after his resurrection, was seen plainly by his disciples, so when he comes as judge, he may show himself merciful to you for all eternity.
Amen.
Amen. And may you who believe he is seated with the Father in his majesty know with joy the fulfillment of his promise to stay with you until the end of time.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go glorify the Lord through our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed weekend.
What hope we have, even in the longest night, for the light will overcome. We will not fear, for we know the sun will rise. Hallelujah is our song. What peace we have, even in this wounded world, where the our souls. Hallelujah is our song. Hallelujah, hallelujah, he is risen over all. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah is our song. Hallelujah. Our song.